So I'm looking around and I'm drinking it all in. And who do I see sitting a few rows in front of me? The one and only Glen Burtnik. How you doing, pal?
Hey, how are you?
All right. You know, I saw you. I was going to scream, but I didn't want to make a fool out of myself. But you were like just in front of me a little bit to the left. And what a great show, wasn't it?
It was terrific. You know, I saw this particular band like about 2.5 years ago.
Right.
And it was exciting. But last night I figured, you know, well, let's just go see it again, whatever. It's a few years in, you know, they've been playing together for a while. So, you know, I just sat down, I had a macaroni dinner, and then I just went to this show and I was blown away. It was, they love each other. You can feel it.
You really can.
These guys, they're all a bunch of pros. They're all superstars in their own right, and they love playing together, and it was all a night of hits.
Did you see the way Lukather and Rundgren were just messing around on stage, you know, playing with each other and running into each other like two little kids?
Amazing. It was an amazing night. And even the guys that you don't know, like the drummer, whose name escapes me right now, mm-hmm. He was incredible. The guy held the band together, you know, and the saxophone player was another guy that you're not going to remember. I don't remember him from any other thing. But so everybody on that stage was holding their own, and a night of hits with my superstar talent, you know.
And that's what you think about it, you know. And I thought of you, and I wanted to get you on because it was fun. It was fun, like watching the show. It was fun watching you watch the show because you've put on shows, and you're going to be doing the British Invasion show at the State April 2nd. You've put on shows where you have reproduced entire albums. So, you know, like, you get what it's like and how hard it is to make that sound as great as it did. And when you talk about an all-star band, that really was one.
Absolutely. And you know, it also takes a certain amount of, you know, check your ego at the door kind of thing. I mean, I'm sure they know who the boss is there. When you're working with a Beatle, you're working, you know, there's nothing greater in the world of pop. But nevertheless, you know, everyone... In that organization, everyone respected each other, and that's a beautiful thing. That's the way all musicians should be. And I'm lucky enough that whenever I hire people, I only try to hire people who are easy to get along with and make music for the joy of it instead of for the ego, you know?
And you could see that, you know, that's what they were doing. Like, you could see they were genuinely having a great time. And, you know, Ringo was comfortable with everything. And the music was so varied because you got the Santana songs, you got the Toto songs, you got the Mr. Mister, you got Todd doing Bang on the Drum, and Ringo playing. You know, it's kind of funny, Glen, you watching Ringo and, you know, with the shoulders up and the sticks and looking up, oh, I see the Ed Sullivan backdrop behind them. He's the same Ringo, and no matter what he's playing, that's the way he plays.
Except he's 75 years old, and he's looking really healthy, man. He's been on a macrobiotic diet, and I was just sitting there thinking, all right, now I got to go on a macrobiotic diet. for about 20 years, he's on a macrobiotic diet, and if you really look closely, he's probably healthier than Paul McCartney.
Oh, yeah. Well, you know, there's a story I saw in his article in Rolling Stone where he was out with Paul and somebody else. I think it was Dave Grohl. And the drinks come around and Paul says to Ringo, you know, come on, go ahead, have a drink. And Ringo says, what, it looked like you? And Paul's like, I had it coming.
Ringo was always the oldest Beatle, and he continues to be so. You know, I mean, he's 75 now, so he was older than John. He's the oldest guy, and he looks sprightly, you know. He looks like a kid up there, you know.
And at one point, I happened to notice that I looked over there, and you were not there. And it's getting toward the end of the show, and I'm thinking, look at this. Is he going to go on stage and play? Are they going to bring him out? And then you came back, and I figured, okay, he probably just went to hit the head like I was going to do.
Yeah, I did. Well, you know what? There was one song that I'm not crazy about.
What was that?
And it was Hold the Line by Toto. I, you know, for me, to see Ringo playing drums to that song, it just irks me. So
is that why you left? Get out of here.
Well, I took that opportunity to go.
Oh, okay. It was hard to pick the song because they were so short, and the next one, you didn't know what it was going to be. And Ringo, I mean, Don't Pass Me By would have been a good one. And I'm surprised he didn't do Octopus's Garden. Now, did you go backstage afterwards and see Bruce?
No, I didn't, no. But you know, I was thrilled. I grew up going to the State Theater, and I've done so many. I've probably done like a dozen shows there of my own now. And it was nice sitting on the other end, sitting in the audience again, and just taking it in. And what a beautiful theater it is, and what a great vibe. Great vibe, man. Everybody in the house was just happy, you know?
All right, my topic this hour. And who better than the great Glen Burtnik, who puts bands together like guys do fantasy football? If you were going to put together the Glen Burtnik All-Starr Band, and you could have anybody at your disposal, what are we doing? I need a guitar, a bass, a keyboard, and a drums.
Wow, that's I came up with three ideas. I could do three different bands.
All right.
There's the dead guys. There's, you know, the people who are no longer with us who I'd love to do.
Okay.
There are the guys who are alive and kicking. That would be great.
All right.
And then there are people who are alive, but they're too burnt out. And even though they'd be, you know, they're geniuses and icons, you know.
All right. Real fast. I got 30 seconds. Give me your guys.
Okay. The dead guys. Ray Manzarek from The Doors on keyboards. Jimi Hendrix on guitar. Amy Winehouse on vocals, Keith Moon on drums, and Chris Squire on bass.
Wow. Good. Next. Wow.
The living guys, the guys that are alive, Prince, Stevie Wonder, Paul McCartney, and the vocalist would be Adele, CeeLo Green, Ann Wilson, and Bonnie Raitt with Flea on guitar.
Okay. And the Burnouts?
And one more, the Burnouts. Brian Wilson on keyboards, Bob Dylan on guitar, Sly Stone on keyboards, Ginger Baker on drums, and Roger Waters on bass. There you go.
All right, I'm putting Glen Burtnik in my living band. April 2nd, British Invasion show. If you've never seen Glen Burtnik perform the British Invasion, you need to see Glen Burtnik perform the British Invasion. We'll have more details as we get closer. Right, pal?
That's right.
You got it. Thanks for coming on, Glen.
All right, man. Take care.
You got it, pal. That's Glen Burtnik.